Working in customer support is never easy. Working in tech support? I can't even imagine. Welcome to this episode of Tales from Tech Support.
Our first tale is from Scorp123CH. Just had a funny support ticket yesterday. Normal users get a mailbox size of 500 megabytes. For normal users, that's enough. You're not supposed to abuse the mail system as archiving solution. We have a separate product for that. But thanks to the current pandemic, it can happen that some users might get a lot more mail traffic than others and might thus run out of space pretty fast. Example, because of attachments and whatnot. So if that happens, a user can open a ticket and request more space. Example, 1 GB, 2 GB, if need be, which we will happily provide. And then, yesterday, we get this ticket from a user who thinks she's particularly entitled to having a super duper large mailbox.
Please increase my mailbox size to 1 exabyte.
So we call her back, thinking that maybe it's just a typo and she actually meant 1 GB.
No, I really mean 1 exabyte, she insists. I need all the mailbox space you can give me. I am so tired of constantly running out of space.
Constantly? Ticket history shows she's only had her mailbox size increased once so far, from 500 megabytes to 800 megabytes, and that was like 1 year ago. Storage analysis shows she's got like 750 megabytes in her mailbox now. So, given the growth of her mailbox over the past year, 1 GB should do just fine for her. If she runs out of that space too, she can request 2 GB in about a year or so. By the way, fellow sysadmins, BS like this is exactly why you don't do zip and anything at all unless there's a ticket ID for it. Document everything and make sure it's in the ticket.
No, I want 1 exabyte.
Of course I refuse. There's no way in this universe I could give her that much space.
I am going to escalate to your manager, she screams.
I can hear my manager's phone ringing. He picks up and the only thing I can hear is, what? That phone call didn't even last 30 seconds. My manager walks to my desk, laughing ear to ear and tears in his eyes. Yeah, right. Just give her 1 GB and then close the ticket. And don't forget to print it out and put a frame on it. That ticket needs to be in our Hall of Fame. Some users. 1 exabyte of mailbox storage for Outlook. Right. It's clearly obvious that she doesn't really delete emails. She's just trying to abuse the system, kind of like you said earlier, and archive everything. So she needs all the space available. This next tale is by Dunachews. I'm not the official tech support person. I'm just the guy everyone goes to because I'm good with computers. Jay comes to me the other day and asks for help with his printer. Okay, let me take a look, Jay. Don't touch anything else. Let me finish filling out this TPS report and I'll be right with you. I go to Jay's workstation and he has his printer open. I looked in and the package to the ink is ripped open. I look at the old cartridge and it's an HP number 39. I look in the printer, it's HP number 37. Jay, you bought the wrong cartridge. Long story short, we have to buy our own cartridges, then expense report them.
It fits.
Jay, it's like you bought an oil filter for a 57 Chevy Bel Air, but you're trying to shove it in a 57 Chevy truck. Close isn't good enough. It has to be exactly the same cartridge.
But it fits.
It's not right. You need to go back and get an HP number 37 or number 37 XL cartridge.
Can I return this one I just bought?
Probably not, because it's opened. Let me get a Ziploc bag and leave me the receipt and I'll throw it on the shelf. And if anyone needs that cartridge, they can give you cash for it. And then this morning, what do you know? My printer ink hits low and lo and behold, I open my printer up and I need the number 39. And PS, why the fuck do we not have a photocopier? I don't have an answer either. The mysteries of some businesses, but someone has to keep HP in business. It amazes me that this guy has made it so far in life if he honestly thinks just because a cartridge fits, or for that matter, anything else, that it's okay and it works. Our next tale is from Night Otter. Many years ago, I was in tech support for a major software vendor. We had a cluster of products that all worked together with our backbone product. One day, I received a call from sales folks. They have a customer who wants a meeting with someone who knows XYZ product. I'm the TS expert for this particular product, so of course they called me. Check schedules and with my manager. Yeah, I can do it on that day and date. This is the first time I've ever even met a customer. So in the morning, I dither about how to dress. Full suit? Just a button down? Tie? Finally, I gave up. Jeans and corp polo shirt. In the meeting room, waiting on the customer is my boss, the director of TS, sales folks, their manager, and the director of sales. I'm feeling seriously underdressed, even as my boss is in a button-down and tie. A few minutes later, another salesperson shows in the customer team. Their guy's in a suit, ignores everyone else, comes straight to me. You must be Otter. I'm blank, director and sponsor of the project at our company. He then introduces two other folks, one of whom is the tech lead for the project. I guess I dressed appropriately as the customer was able to pick the techie out of a room full of people. They explain their project and how they see our product fitting in. They start peppering me with questions. I'm asking them questions. The whiteboard fills with notes and diagrams. Sales folks offer to get us drinks. Our directors say they'll get the drinks. I found out later the director of sales didn't want his sales guys to miss anything. After 30 minutes, the sales folks' eyes have glazed over. Tech lead and I are way deep in how the product works. I asked my boss and director, is it okay to go this deep? Yes. We were completely redesigning the project. We paused. Tech lead looked at his director. Are you okay with what we're doing? He nods, so we keep going. Another hour later, their project is now centered around our product, not just using it, and the design hooks are there to use other products from us. A few weeks later, I receive a $1,000 bonus from the sales team. 6 months later, I was promoted, with this meeting cited as one of the reasons for the promotion. I ended doing many technical meetings like this with customers and even ended up on the trade show circuit. It's amazing how like business meetings in general, especially in this kind of situation, can be slightly intimidating when you're meeting with all the heads and big people and you're not sure how to dress. I'm glad everything worked out great for you and I'm glad that you ended up getting promoted because you did so well. And our final one is from Comandanto en Bavajo. Years ago, I got my first junior sysadmin job at a small academic department at a university. I've since moved on to greater things, but my former boss Leonard still finds occasion to email me. I came back from lunch today to find the following email from Leonard. Hey, I keep finding this script, lart.sh, everywhere. It says you're the author. What is it? Can I get rid of it? Uh-oh. See, Leonard was incompetent, and the most irritating aspect of his incompetency was his utter inability to communicate. In particular, he had a habit of making breaking configuration changes on servers I was responsible for, then asking me to troubleshoot them, while withholding the fact that he had made any changes. So I wrote LART, the Leonard Activity Reporting Tool. LART would query audit the Linux security event logging daemon and generate a tidy report showing his recent logins, what commands he had run, and whether he had modified any configuration files. LART quickly became an invaluable tool in my repertoire. Every time he had asked me to troubleshoot a problem, my first step was to run LART to see what kind of fuckery Leonard had been up to recently. Obviously, I couldn't tell him this, so I replied, "Hi Leonard, that's my Linux activity reporting tool. It shows recent security events. Feel free to delete it. Have a great day." It's gotta be bad if you work at a company with someone that's clearly so incompetent and breaking everything that you have to write a special tool to monitor that specific person. Alright, that's enough tales for the day. Well, that wraps up this episode of Tales from Tech Support. If you liked the video, please drop a like, share my content on all of your social media, subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time I upload, and drop a comment down below. Thanks for watching. Thanks to my patrons. Have a great day and stay safe out there.